Hi all, welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to start with lesson number 3. So this is lesson number 3 for the complete course IP session 21-22. Myself, Anjali, and I have 16 years of experience in teaching IP and CS, and you get everything related to this subject. Everything related to the subject means the theory lessons, the practical lessons, the notes, the sample papers, practical file, report file, project file, everything, whatever you need throughout the session, you will be getting here. So without waiting for even a single second, subscribe the channel right now and share it in your WhatsApp group, Telegram group of your class so that your other classmates, other batchmates should also take the advantage of this. Right now, we all are having online classes. So this is the best way we can connect with each other. I also have a link of Telegram channel in the description below. So you can join that Telegram channel so that you can be more interactive to me. Like we can talk about your doubts and other problems as and when you need to talk to me. And another thing is, I'm a plus educator on An Academy, so my profile link is also given in the description. You can follow me there. I have both type of classes there, that is special classes, which are free. Anyone can attend with my name as a code, that is Anjali Luthra. And we have paid classes over there as well. So whichever suits you, you can join in. You're most welcome to join that. The interface is really amazing. And An Academy has all best educators of India to provide quality education from CBSE 6th to CBSE 12th, right? So right now we are going to start with our topic, that is creating a series using dictionary. In the previous class, we created series. We created series using list. Now today, we are going to create it using dictionary. Now, as you know, dictionary is a collection of key value pairs, right? So you should know the definition of dictionary first before you use it as a mode to create a series. So dictionary is said to be a set of key value pairs. For example, if I want to take a dictionary where I have key value pairs, like I should have admission number as key and name of the student as the value. So if you have to create that, how do you write? You write to. We use curly bracket for creating a dictionary, right? We have all different brackets for everything. As you remember in 11th, we have this round bracket for tuple, we have square bracket for list, we have curly bracket for dictionary, and we have quotes for strings, right? Now, if I have the admission number as 1563 and the name is, let's say, Ankita, then your admission number is 2014 and the name is Rohan, something like that. So this is how you can create a dictionary. You can have any number of values in it, but everything is made of a key and a value, so that they are made up of key value pair. Now, when you create a series out of this, when you create a series out of this dictionary, what happens is the key becomes the index. So key will become the index and value will become the data. So if this thing is turned into a series, my two indices will be 1563-2014. So index will be 1563-2014 and the data for index 1563 will be Ankita. Data for 2014 will be Rohan. So simple thing, always remember this, whenever you convert a dictionary to a series, right? So whenever a dictionary is converted to a series, the key values are converted to index and the values are converted to the data. Simple. So in this case, your index will never be 012. Like in case of list, it used to be that we have your index coming as 0123, but here you won't have that because you don't have default indices. Your keys will always used as the index. Although if you want that, no, this should not be the index, you want some other index, you can do it the same way as we did it with list. I'll show you how. Now let's take this example. I'm going to create the same thing, and after that we will be discussing this example. But before we discuss this example, let's create this program. And this is, I'm going to create a new Python file. And the name is creating a series, so I give it a name as S2. Already exist. S2 is already there, so we give another name. Never mind. So let it be SER2. So I create that. I write import pandas as PD, right? Now you have to create a dictionary. So I write like stu is equal to same dictionary, which I just told you, I'm going to create something like that only. So I'm going to take the name Then I have the other admission number. I have the name. Then I have admission number. I take a name. So like this, you can take as many as you want. There is no limit to that. Now you want to create a series. So I create a series. I write S1 is equal to PD dot series in the round brackets. Just write the name of the dictionary. You can write data is equal to stu as well, or just write stu, right? Just write this much. And then we write print S1, and then you execute this program. So I want to execute SER2, so I click on this and run SER2, and you would see this result. So dtype is taken as object, your keys are taken as index, and your values are taken as data. So if you want to show only 145, I can write 145. I save it and I run this. So you can see only Rohan is coming because Rohan is at 145. Got it? So that's how indexing works in case of dictionaries. I gave that at a wrong place. We had to give it over here. That's why it was showing you index 0, because I had to give the index while printing, not at the time of creating the series. So yeah, this is how we get Rohan. Earlier, it was creating a series of only one element, that was Rohan. That's why the index was coming as 0. So here we are getting Rohan. So you have to give the index while printing. If you want to change the name, you can change the name as well, because data is mutable. So data is mutable. You can modify the data in the series, but you cannot add new elements to the series. You can't remove, because it is size immutable. So you have to always remember that a series is data mutable, but it is size immutable. If you don't want these indices, you don't want that the index should be taken as what it is right now. So what can you do for that? So if it is coming like this and you don't want the index to be 1, 2, 3, you want like S1, S2, S3, you can do that as we did earlier. Your index attribute can still be used even if you are creating a series with the help of dictionary. You can still give the index of your own choice. So you can give over here S1, S2, S3. And now when I execute this, I'll be getting index as S1, S2, S3 and not as the keys of the dictionary. So whatever index you specify here, that will be taken. This will be overwritten. Clear? So that's how we create a dictionary. We create a series using a dictionary. Fine. One thing. Now this is a very interesting program. Someone asked me for this. I created it, so I thought you also should go through it. And this is like creating a series using a list, which we did in the last class, right? So slowly, as we'll gradually work on things, we will be practicing lot of programs. So whenever you also get a program which you think like how it would be created, feel free to ask me. Feel free to ask me anytime, right? Like this question. This question is asked by one of you all, means one of the students. And she asked me that, ma'am, we have to make a series, but we have to ask the values from the user. We have to ask the values from the user and then we have to put us into a series. So I have to input marks of 5 subjects. After taking the marks in 5 subjects, I have to create a series of that, right? And then I have to see that if the marks are somewhere between 30 to 33, we have to give a grace marks of 3. Got the question? What is the question? That you have to input 5 marks, put them in a series. Then if the marks are somewhere between 30 to 33, we have to give 3 grace marks. So see, how do we do it? We write import pandas as PD. Fine. I am taking a blank list here. I cannot change the size of a series once it's created, but I can do that with a list. So I have taken a blank list here. The loop is working 5 times for I in range 5. I ask the user to enter a marks. So M is equal to int input enter marks. User is going to enter marks. And we have a function called append, which is there to work on list. You would have done it in class 11th. List.append and the value which will be added at the end of the list. So in MK list, the marks gets appended. So whatever you input, that is added into that. So the list is created with 5 values entered by the user. Now I create a series of that. So I write S1 is equal to PD.SeriesMK. So whatever 5 values we have taken in the list, it creates a series of that, and that series is this one. Right now, if I comment these lines, so we have hash symbol to comment your code. Comment means it won't be executed. So it is written there, but won't be executed because it is in the comments. So if I run this, you can see the message coming, enter marks. I enter some marks, and as I keep entering the marks, it is stored and printed. So your original series is this, right? It shows 5 marks it took, and the same 5 marks are stored in the series, and the data type is int 64 by default. Now they say that you have to check. Now for checking, what I can do, I can take a loop, because we know that series is indexed and you can check the values with the help of index. Moreover, series is data mutable, you can modify the data. So I have taken this loop for I in range 5 again. Now it is going to check S1 0 greater than equal to 30. So if your S1 0 is greater than equal to 30 and it is less than equal to 33, that means it lies between these numbers. So I should add 3 grace marks to that. So if this condition is true, extra 3 will be added to that value at that particular index, for the index where the condition is true. That's it. The loop will continue for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And final updated value is printed over here. So if I execute this now, I save it and I execute it. So now I'm going to enter, let's say 78. Now I enter 32. This is 76. Then it's 31 and 45. So I have 32 and 31, which lies in the range. So you can see, once we run this, this 32 has become 35 and 31 has become 34. So it was 32, 31 initially, but after the update, it is modified. So that shows that your series is data mutable. You can modify the data of the series anytime you want. Got it? Now, similar way, there was one more question asked by a student, and that question was, you have to create a series of 5 numbers. The question is, create a series of 5 numbers. What's the question? I'll just write it so that you should understand it in a better way. So create a series of 5 numbers where the numbers are prime. The numbers are prime. Such kind of questions, they don't come in the exam. They can be asked in the practicals, but they won't come in the theory exam. Neither the previous one nor this one. In exams, you get very basic questions. In exams, you will be getting very basic questions like, see how series can be created, what are the attributes of the series, the output of the same. So it's not of that level. So I'm telling you, wherever the question is supposed to come in the board exam, I'll tell you which type of question comes in the board exam and which one is for your coding practice. So this is for your coding practice. This is not going to come in the board written exam. It can come in the practical exam if your school is making you do such programs, right? So create a series of 5 numbers where numbers are prime above 200. So you have to start from 200, and whichever number is prime after that, you have to put 5 prime numbers in a series, right? So basically you have to first put them in a list and then make a series out of that. So if you have to create a program like similar to this one, so I can do one thing. I can copy this whole code, or let's make a new one only. So if this is your practical file, I go and make a new Python file. This is prime. And obviously for this, you should know the logic to find whether a number is prime or not. This you would have done in your class 11th. So import pandas as PD. After import pandas as PD, you should take num. We have to start from 200 plus. So let it be 201. I take a count. So count is initially 0. We don't have any prime number till now. We haven't got any prime number. Now I have to take this loop while count is less than 5. Till count is less than 5, I have to keep repeating because I have to get 5 numbers. And those numbers have to be stored in a list. So I can take a list which is initially blank. Nothing is there in the list. Now I need to check if the num is a prime number or not. If num is a prime number, I should add it to the list. If it is not, I should just increase it by 1 and keep working till I get 5 prime numbers. So for checking whether num is a prime number or not, I can have a loop that will start like for I in range 2, comma, num. I'm not going to explain you the logic for prime number in this. I'm assuming that you know how to check a prime number. So if num mod I is equal to 0, That means if we get a factor, if we get a factor, the number is not a prime number. So when we know the number is not a prime number, there is no point continuing the loop. You should come out of the loop. Else means the loop completed all its iterations and it is a prime number. So now if it is a prime number, so what should I do? I should add that number in the list and I should increase count by one, that we have got one more prime number. And num is something which has to increase by one every time. So num was 201, next time it will be 202, then it will be 203, 204, 205 and so on. And that is it. I've got the list which has five prime numbers. Now you just want to create a series of that. So we should write pd.series and inside that you pass your list and then you print it. And by default, the index will be 0, 1, 2, 3. If you don't want the index to be 0, 1, 2, 3, so you can obviously give the index in the form of a list. Like if I want it to be P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, right? So that's how I can create it. And finally, I'm just going to print the series. So the ones who love programming, they would enjoy this program. And the ones who are not good with loops in class 11, they would be thinking, ma'am, what are you doing? What the hell is this? So don't think, what the hell is this? It is a very simple thing and it won't be asked in your board exam. So chill, right? Just understand the logic. This is only to improve your programming skills, not going to be asked in the board exams. Now I'm just going to run it for you. So if I run this for you and once we execute it, index is the invalid. Where did I give? Okay, I gave the index at the right place. So the index is not in the print. The index, I was writing here, don't know how come it just shifted down. So obviously it has to be when you're creating the series, right? So let's execute it once again and here you are. So 211, 223, 227, 229 and 233. P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 are your prime numbers. Got it? So that's how we solve this question. Was an interesting question for the ones who love programming. Otherwise, the ones who could not understand because of the logic of prime numbers, don't take it on your heart. It's okay. It's fine. We have just started. We will be practicing a lot. And believe me, after practicing with me for a few days, you would start liking such kind of programs as well. But the major thing from today's lesson which you have to learn is how to create a series using dictionary, right? So the previous time I gave you two questions to make with the help of list. You have to do the same with the help of dictionary now and write the answers in the comments.